Hello, my name is Kathy Pham, and I am here to tell you about my story falling in love with computer science. It all started in high school. I didn't know what programming was. I had no idea what computer science was, but I had a great geometry teacher who decided to bring programming to our school that year. Thanks, Mrs. Strife. She came up to me and basically asked if I wanted to take a programming class my senior year. And I figured, oh, a computer class, easy thing to do. I'll just cruise on by, have one easy class for my senior year before graduation. It wasn't super easy, but it turned out I completely loved programming. I loved building a program to write up a receipt where I entered information like apples and oranges and tax rate, and it printed out a receipt that is completely customized to what I wanted it to be. And from that moment, I knew there was something about this programming thing that I really enjoyed. So when I went to college next year at Georgia Tech, I had to pick a major, had no idea what I should do, and figured, you know what? I'll just pick computer science, and I can always change it later. Turns out, I really, really enjoyed my first year. The class was in Scheme. Similar to Pascal, no one had heard of Scheme either, and it was just this language with lots of parentheses. I loved it nonetheless. I loved the way it made me think logically, and I just loved writing functions that can do what I told it to. So then I continued to really fall in love with the College of Computing at Georgia Tech, loved staying up, studying late at night. I became a student ambassador for Google and brought pizza to all of our study sessions. I loved my professors, advisors, the classes, and really just had a great time. But it wasn't always easy. I had a really hard time my freshman year. I put up a putty screen here because I remember a moment when after class or during class, the teaching assistant told us to go home and log into one of the College of Computing servers. I didn't really know what a server was, didn't know what a terminal was, just had no idea what he was talking about, and I just remember thinking, oh man, this isn't for me. And I had a great TA that had me install PuTTY and showed me how to SSH into a terminal, and it was great after that. But that really drove me to be a teaching assistant as well, so I could help other freshman students who came to the College of Computing a little confused like I was. So that was also a lot of fun. So after that, during my time at Georgia Tech, I explored lots of different things. I knew I was interested in healthcare to the point where I actually was taking pre-med classes, thought I might want to go to med school, and thought, well, you know, I should explore everything, and had a research assistantship at a microarray bioinformatics lab at Georgia Tech, and fell in love with the idea of using data and bioinformatics to do something good for the world. So that led to an internship at Google. I interviewed for a summer internship as an associate product manager at Google. One of my interviewers had asked, tell me just something that isn't really on your resume that you just really care about. So I started talking about my love for healthcare, that I had done some work in this microarray lab, really liked bioinformatics. Didn't think it had anything to do with Google because Google did search and maps and email, and turns out they were looking for someone for Google Health that summer. So I spent the summer with some of these interns here and really absolutely loved studying, learning more about computer science and data and just learning how it all can tie together in healthcare. So I loved computer science so much that I decided to stay for a master's program. I flew over to Paris, France, and I had a great excuse to tell my mom I was doing something with my life, but really go live and enjoy my time in France while getting a computer science degree. The university was actually in this beautiful city called Metz, a little outside of Paris, and I had my computer science program jointly with Supélec, a French university. I learned conversational French, learned to absolutely love and embrace the French culture and food, met some wonderful friends, and also had an internship at ENRIA, a French university, or a French research institute. So I had a wonderful time there. Near the end of my time as a graduate student, an opportunity to participate in the Microsoft Imagine Cup. That's basically the World Cup, but instead of for soccer, it's for nerds. And it's held in a different city every year. I found a partner to enter with me into this competition, and we actually ended up with first place in the Microsoft Imagine Cup and had a wonderful time building a tool to address one of the United Nations Millennium Development Goals. So after I graduated, I had to figure out something to do with my life in the real world. Got a wonderful opportunity to go live along the Space Coast of Florida and work at Harrahs Healthcare Solutions, finding ways to use software to find solutions for some of the hospital problems that we have today. And what that also meant was that I saw many rocket launches, I learned to surf, and I got to live along the Space Coast of Melbourne and just really enjoy a wonderful beachy lifestyle. But I missed the big city. So I had an opportunity then to become a business consultant for IBM, building and testing data warehouses for hospital clients around the country in many cool cities. One of my fondest memories while I did this was when I ran my first ever half marathon. I trained for my first ever half marathon with my team that was in Nashville with me at the time while I was living in Orlando. So I had a lot of fun times flying around with IBM. However, it wasn't always fun times. There were times when I was delayed, late nights on Thursdays. This is a photo of when I was snowed in Roanoke, Virginia one time. And I just really just missed my family after flying around for so long. So I found a new role. At that time, Google was hiring for a data analyst role. So I came back to Google. I'm currently a data analyst for our staffing and hiring and all the people data. But before I actually could start at Google, my mom was diagnosed with leukemia. And I never thought that everything I had learned with computer science, with healthcare, with program management, with consulting, with learning to just fly around on last minute's notice would really prepare me for one of the most important roles I'd ever have in my life. And that was be a patient advocate for my mom during her battle with leukemia. She was diagnosed last year in August 2013, and I'm happy to say that she had her last round of chemo on October 6, 1 year and 2 months after diagnosis. Hooray. So that gives me time to go back to Google and continue my love affair with computer science, focusing on data. I also do things like Girls Who Code on the side and support our K-12 initiatives in addition to really working with our business intelligence community here at Google. So what really started out as a chance encounter in high school has turned into many academic, personal, professional adventures in computer science. I don't know what the future holds, but I'm excited to continue this adventure, and I hope that your passions and love for whatever field you decide to join, and maybe it is one related to science, technology, engineering, or math, will take you on many great adventures as well. Thank you.